plan for today was to go up the coast and chase kingfish and do a little bit of soft baiting, but the northerly wind has kicked up quite a bit. So in the name of still going fishing and being flexible, we've decided to adjust the plan. We're going to jump on the tinny and probably be restricted to staying inside one bay, but we're just going to see what we can do. Let's go. Peekaboo. Why?
No, I'm not in his hips.
Yes, you are. Look.
No, I'm not.
She is.
No, I'm not. Today's about you, baby. I got already my biggest fish. I'm happy. We can go.
We're in for a day of probably quite hard fishing, but we're just going to go and give it a crack. Let's go.
These things are on.
Oh.
Oh, no. The tractor's flat. I'll go grab the other car with the jump starter. Why are those on, though? Is the boot open?
Ah, probably. Oops. Wrong one.
Got that sorted. Let's go fishing.
No water again.
No water. Dead low tide. We know we're in for a bit of a walk today, but I'm pretty keen to get out there anyway.
Where the boat gets stuck. It should be over there more.
Our little tinny through here. She's touching the bottom a fair bit though. Just gonna keep picking the best part. Fresh bait. That's what we got. Bag full of fresh herrings. Beautiful. Got Juju cleaning the net for us, getting all of our fresh baits out and popping them into the bucket as I walk the boat down the harbour because it's dead low tide, and eventually we're going to get to the ocean just around the corner there. Now it's blowing a bit of an ugly northerly that we weren't really expecting, but it's super super calm where we are now. I think we're going to be able to fish inside this bay here and we should be in for a pretty cool day. We're going to try and make it happen. Actually got the boat going now, so safety first, always got my life jacket. Let's go.
Pop the soft bait for a second, see if I can pick up a kahawai here. I find the white one's really, really effective on kahawai. It's the White Warrior soft bait.
Change of plan, back to grocery fishing, yeah. Back to my favorite BKK circle hooks, the simple system. So we have to fish the backyard again, which isn't all that bad, but it limits the options a little bit. First bait going down is going to be a whole pilly. So I'm going to go through my pilly, all the way out and around, and over the top, and then back through them again. And then finally I'm just going to put the hook through those gill plates. They're a bit harder and should hold the hook in place. There you go, beautiful pilly bait.
Damn, that
just got absolutely smashed. The whole just got absolutely smoked.
I have to put another one on.
A few days of hard fishing just lately, so I'd be happy if we get onto them today.
I really love these hooks, eh? Like, look at that, guys. Beautifully corner of the mouth. Almost every single time.
The same way.
Yeah, and that's what you want. So your fish can come off the hook easily, you can get back to fishing quickly, and if you want to release the fish, you can do so safely and quickly. Not this guy, though. It's great to see that the fish are back on the farm. After a few really quiet days, we're out here to do our grocery shopping today. The weather's packed up on us, so it's grocery fishing, and I'm pretty happy to see there's a few good fish around. You never know, we might hit a monster. Yeah, hooked up on the hand light. Oh no, right up against the muscle line. It's a good fish. Another good example of the BKK circle hook doing its job beautifully. Corner of the mouth, just where you want them. So it rolls out nicely, and then that fish can safely be ickied and put in the ice. Another one, fish after fish. Proper ice slurry, look after your fish. Bit of a different day. The fish are really on today. Deadly. Feels like another really good fish. Whoa. Great fish. Same thing. How's that? Another great penny. Beautiful fish.
Good.
Well, I say not very big, he's still not a bad fish by the feels of things, but it's quite a big bait, so I was trying to catch a real big one out the back there, and this panny has come along and sucked it up, but by no stretch is that a bad fish at all. Still a great fish. But while they seem to be on good form, I'm going to put a few of these guys back and hopefully catch bigger ones. Hopefully they get bigger. So here's those herrings that I cast netted earlier. I'm just turning them into absolute dynamite snapper baits. Bit of a combo bait there. Beautiful. Fish. We'll let this fella go though. It's early days. Still be monsters coming, I reckon. Right. There he is. Good old hand line. And got all the fancy rods out the back, and the hand line's doing the damage today. Just how it goes some days. One of my favourite ways to catch a feed. So simple, beautiful fish. Good fish. Almost every single fish, corner of the mouth, absolutely flawless. Look at that. You could not ask for easier than that.
absolutely beautiful. Love those hooks. Great fish too. Awesome.
So I'll break one up and throw it in the water. And I'll put my baits down right in the middle of it. Yep, there we go.
Same problem as that one's hooked up. Perfect. Accidentally caught myself a big snapper while I was busy over there catching fish bait. Never a problem. Oh, yes. Not bad at all.
Wow. Great fish.
Bad fish either. Coming up. What's this? Beautiful. Nice red, eh?
What's that one? I'll let that one go too. It's another beautiful fish, but we're doing all right, so we'll pop this guy back and see if we can upgrade to something even bigger.
Later, mate. Back to that perfect sized little kawai I caught. I'm going to whip a couple of big baits off this guy and pop one out the back and see if there's any really big snapper out there. You never know.
Look at that, he's full of my herring. He's full of my burley. Look at this. He's been scoffing up all my burley. Got all of that back, I get to reuse it. Perfect.
Quietly, massively there. Look at that.
What?
Look at that fish. Piece of that fresh kahawai bait. Done the damage. Fish, not huge, but he's a goodie. He was trying to be clever. The way he was eating that bait was crack up. Oh, got him. There he is. Not a bad sized fish, but nothing spectacular. Just another great panty sort of size. We've got a good feed there, so I'll pop this guy back as well. Ho, 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 ho. Easy, mate. Beautifully hooked again. Gotta love those hooks. Nice fresh Mackie. Beautiful. I love these guys as a snapper bait. It's cool when they catch them without bait.
There we go. Nice fresh Mackie bait. See how we go with that.
Last bait, she reckons.
Alright, let's go for this big piece of Mackie.
Go through there. Roll that around. I'll pop that back through. Again, just for a bit extra hold.
Now that's a big bait, so I'm going to have to let this one get eaten and let the fish run away with it a little bit. But that looks pretty delicious to me. He's trying to eat it. I don't know if he's big enough. Might be the problem. Might be sort of, you know, 7-8 pounder trying to eat that massive bait. But
he's pretty committed to it. He keeps coming back.
He's back again. Look at that. He's back again. pretty cool. No. Oh. Pulled the head off that time.
We're not gonna get to see him.
Oh well, the sun's setting. We've had an epic little session. Unfortunately, that last really big fish didn't come back, but that gives me a great reason to get back out here as soon as possible. Hope you guys enjoyed this little mission. Cheers, time to go home. Let's go. Thanks for watching, and we hope you enjoyed this episode. Remember to like and subscribe, and check us out on other platforms if you'd like to see more content.